वेलकम स्टूडेंट, आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर इज लेक्चर 20 ऑफ यूनिट 3। इन दिस लेक्चर वी टॉक अबाउट फोर्जिंग प्रोसेसेस। इन फोर्जिंग प्रेस द कंप्रेसिव फोर्स इज अप्लाइड कंटिन्यूसली एंड द मटेरियल इज ग्रेजुअली प्रेस ऑन स्क्वेज्ड इनटू शेप। They also usually operate in vertical position like the hammer. The various forging presses employed for the forging processes discussed below. This is the some forging presses as shown in this figure, which is used like a crank mechanism, knuckle joints, hydraulic press machine or screw press machines. In mechanical press machines, they are of either the crank or a eccentric type as shown in figure A and B, with a speed varying from maximum at the center of the stroke to zero at the bottom. Hence, mechanical presses are stroke limited. The force available depend on stroke position, become extremely large at the bottom dead center position. Thus, proper setup is essential to avoid breaking the dies or other equipments. Mechanical forging press make use of electric motor to drive a flywheel mounted on counter shaft. The power is transmitted from pulley to motor of the flywheel by means of the belt drive. The power from the counter shaft is transmitted to crankshaft by means of the gearing. Connecting dog mounted on crankshaft convert the rotating motion into reciprocating motion. Ram, which is attached to the connecting rod, give blow to the workpiece held between the die. The large mechanical press has the capacity of 107 MN. The speed ranges from 25 to 60 stroke per minute as shown in this figure. In hydraulic press machine as shown in figure C, where have a constant low speed and are load limited. Large amount of the energy can be transmitted to the workpiece by the constant load available throughout the stroke. A hydraulic press typically consists of piston, cylinder, ram and hydraulic pumps driven by electric motors. The ram speed can be varied during the stroke. These presses are usually for both open die and closed die forging operation. The large hydraulic press in the extension have capacity of 670 MN, which is the more compared to mechanical presses. Okay, now we talk about the screw presses that drive their energy from flywheel. In screw presses with the help of flywheel as shown in this figure, the forging load is transmitted through a vertical screw. This press are energy limited and can be used for many forging operations. A screw press consists of a screw which passes through a nut as shown in this figure. Passes through a nut. The head of a screw is connected to the flywheel and the tail is and it costs. But they require less maintenance joint with the ram. The ram move up and down by the screw as the flywheel is driven by rotating disc. They are particularly suitable for producing small quantities for part required precision such as turbine blades and for control of ram speed. The large screw press has capacity of 280 MN. Now we compare the forward or direct extrusion to backward or indirect extrusion. In forward extrusion, the flow of metal is in the same direction as the movement of the ram. But in backward direction, in this case, the metal flow in the opposite direction. Forward flow, the high friction force must be overcome, but in compared to backward motion, the low friction force are generated as the mass of metal does not move. in forward extrusion, high extrusion force required, but mechanically simple and uncomplicated. But compared to backward extrusion process, 25-30% less extruding force is required compared to direct extrusion. But hollow ram required limited application because it is difficult to make a hollow ram for this process. In forward extrusion, high scrap or material waste, about 8-20% on an average. But in backward forging process, low scrap of material waste, only 5-6% of the billet weight. Now we compare hot extrusion and cold extrusion. In hot extrusion process, heated billet is used, but in cold extrusion process, unheated billet is used. In hot extrusion process, less ductile metal can be extruded, but in backward extrusion process, ductile metal can be extruded. In forward extrusion, more scrap. In backward extrusion, less scrap. In forward extrusion, less surface finish, but in cold extrusion process, good surface finish. In backward extrusion process, less expensive, but cold extrusion process is more expensive because it required more force compared to hot extrusion process. So we require more powerful machines, so it's this process cost is increases because of the high cost machines. Now oxidation and scale on exist because temperature is higher than decrystallization temperature, so environmental oxygen react with metal and oxide the metal, which makes surface is bad surface finish. But in cold extrusion pressure, no oxidation or scale on the surface. Hot extrusion process, low production rate, because first we increase the temperature, then we perform the operation. But in cold extrusion process, not required any type of the temperature increasing process. We operate this performance this operation perform on the room temperature easily. Metal flow in extrusion process. Because the billet is a force through die with substantial reduction in its cross section, the metal flow pattern in the extrusion is an important factor in overall process. The most homogeneous flow pattern is obtained when there is no friction at the billet container die interface. This type of the flow occurs when the lubricant is very effective with indirect extrusion. When friction along all interfaces is high, the dead zone developed where no metal flow takes place. When friction along all interface is high, the dead zone developed where no metal flow takes place. Also in hot working, the metal near the container wall cool rapidly, has increase in strength, thus the metal in center region flow toward the die more easily than the outer region. As a result, a large dead metal zone form and the flow is inhomogeneous. Thus the two factors that greatly influence the metal flow in extrusion are frictional condition, the blade container, the die interference and temperature gradient in the billet. So two factors are influence the metal flow. First, the solidification of the work material which is contact with container, because it cooled first or fastly because container heat transfer, workpiece
heat is transferred to container.
And other is the friction to influence the flow of material. Now we talk about the mechanism of extrusion process. The geometric variable of basic extrusion process are die angle and the reduction ratio of extrusion ratio. Extrusion ratio determine the ratio of cross-section area bullet to the cross-section area of the extruded product. As you see in the figure, the extrusion force which is required to perform the operation, which is F is equal to A naught multiply K multiply log A naught upon AF, where K is the extrusion constant. A naught and AF are the billet and extruded product after the operation, respectively, in direct extrusion process. The effect of friction between container wall and billet cause the ram pressure to be greater than in direct extrusion. Okay, this is the some mechanism of where we easily find out what is the parameter we use in the formula. That is the some questions. With the help of the equations, we simply find out the value of. Thank you very much.